Hello, my name is Cole Reimer from GE Digital, and today I'll be walking you through the installation of Microsoft SQL Server Express 2017. When using the CIMPLICITY product, one of the most common capabilities is to have CIMPLICITY communication with an SQL Server. This video will go through the installation of Microsoft's SQL Server Express 2017 so that it can be used with the CIMPLICITY product features such as the database logger, change approval, or DGR. This video will walk through the initial installation of the SQL Server Express. For this video, we will be using SQL Server Express 2017 and installing it on the Microsoft Windows Server 2016 operating system. The prerequisites for this installation are to have the SQL Server Express 2017 installation media, which is downloaded directly from Microsoft. For the purposes of this video, we will be using the online installer provided by Microsoft's website. When installing the SQL Server, you'll be prompted for three main pieces of information: the instance name, the authentication mode, and the password for the default system administrator, or SA, user. The instance name for the SQL Server represents the unique SQL Server instance that is installed on the system. Microsoft's SQL Server allows multiple installations to be installed on the same computer, so the instance name is a method to uniquely identify each installation. When connecting to the SQL Server, the connection is usually in the form of the server name, a backslash, followed by the instance name. For this video, we'll be using an instance name of CIMPLICITY. The authentication mode determines who is able to connect to the SQL Server. There are two types of authentication available: Windows and mixed mode authentication. When using an SQL Server with CIMPLICITY, mixed mode authentication is required. This allows the user to specify a specific SQL username and password when connecting to it. As we are configuring for mixed mode authentication, the installer will prompt for the password for the default system administrator, or SA, account. Microsoft's SQL Server Express install enforces password constraints on any password provided to ensure it is secure. When you are prompted for the password, writing down the password would be a good idea. This information will be required later when attempting to connect to the SQL Server. Let's get started by double-clicking on the executable that has been downloaded to install the SQL Server. The SQL Server Express installation will start and begin to get things ready. Once it is ready, it will prompt us as to what type of installation to do. In this video, we'll be choosing a custom installation. It will then ask where to download the media to. Choose a location on disk and click the Install button when ready. The installer will now download all of the necessary files required for the installation, and when complete, it will start the installer for the SQL Server Express. When the installer starts, we will want to choose the new SQL Server or standalone installation when prompted. Accept the license terms when prompted and click Next. The installer will now evaluate the system to confirm the prerequisites are met. Once the confirmation of prerequisites is complete, click the Next button to continue. You will now be prompted to choose which components to install of the SQL Server. The main component is the Database Engine Services, and if you would like to leave the other defaults, that is fine as well. At this point, you will be given the opportunity to install to a non-standard location. If you choose to do so, that is perfectly fine, but for this video, we will be using the default installation location. Click Next when ready. The installer will now prompt you for the database instance name. As mentioned earlier in the video, we will be using an instance name of CIMPLICITY. Click Next when done. You will now be prompted to set the SQL Server Services start settings. We will leave these at defaults and click Next when done. We will next be prompted for the authentication mode. Choose Mixed Mode SQL Server Authentication and type in a strong password for the default system administrator, i.e. SA user. I would highly suggest writing down the password at this point. The installer will now continue, and when it is complete, you will be notified. When the installer is complete, it will say installation was successful. When it says installation is successful, the installation of the SQL Server Express has been finished. However, there are still additional steps to ensure that client applications such as CIMPLICITY can connect to it. In the next video, we will discuss the steps needed to configure the SQL Server for local and remote access.